Yes, greetings, my friends. Yes, how are you? Yes, I'm on Junior Rukundo. My friends, I'm here again. I wanna share what happened in this dream. Family, I will give you Bible verses about silence. What does the Bible say about silence? But first of all, I'll first explain how it happened. How did I receive this dream? What were in this dream? Who are the people involved in this dream? Family, I'm gonna explain everything. Relax. I'm gonna explain. Family, I was somewhere. I've had a meeting. We are somewhere with my OBs and OGs from my school, Pride Academy, Tsugu, Kampala. So I met them at a football pitch, and the football pitch I saw in this dream is a Chiuliza football pitch, which is a playground which is located in Kisugu Namongo at a school called Chiuliza Primary School. By the way, this is my primary school, from nursery to from baby to primary 70s. I met these ogies there. So I met a certain group of ogies and obis. We were somewhere discussing, sitting, chilling, drinking, enjoying, having fun, having some snacks. And I saw my OB sitting somewhere. I asked them, what's they said, he's there, he's working on some things, he's finishing up some things. And I said, okay, let me go and talk to him. I went there. This OB I saw was sitting somewhere at the pitch side. It's called Elias Tewa. I spoke to him. I called him, Elias, what's wrong? What's wrong, my OB, my beloved OB? What's happening? He told me, no. I don't have any problem, I'm okay. He was like, yeah. I told him, are you sure? He said, yes, I'm okay. I told him, so what's why you sitting, why you apart, why you far from your friends? Your friends are the other side, you are this side. He's like, he told me, I'm on, I'm just thinking about some things, just for a few seconds. I'm also, as I'm speaking to the Lord, but I'm on, trust me, I'm okay, I'm okay, I'm on. When I have a problem, I'm on, I can, of course, it's better you open and tell people, but I'm okay, I'm thinking, there are some things I'm planning, just for a few seconds, but after I'm going to come, I'm gonna join you. When he told me, I think I'm on, you understand that. I told him, when you tell me you're speaking to the Lord, yeah, having think about some things. I told him, I understand that, Elias, I understand that. So I told him, Obi, okay, it's okay, God bless you, when you finish up you come and join us. So family, that's what happened in this dream. And family, people in most cases, when someone maybe decides maybe to be silent, some people are like, no, what's wrong with this person? Sometimes this is necessary. Though not always, but it's necessary. So what do you learn from this? I'll give you Bible verses about silence, and you'll go and read what the Bible says about silence. Not so. Family, I'll give you a Bible verses about silence. Family, go and read Ecclesiastes chapter 9 verse 17, go and read Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 7 to 8, go and read Proverbs chapter 17 verse 28, go and read Proverbs chapter 10 verse 19, go and read Proverbs chapter 21 verse 23, go and read Ephesians chapter 4 verse 29, go and read Psalms 141 verse 3, family, go and read Zephaniah chapter 1 verse 7, family, go and read Psalms 37 verse 7, family, go and read Proverbs chapter 19 verse 20 to 21, family, go and read Psalms 62 verse 5 to 6, family, also go and read Mark chapter 1 verse 35. Family, in these verses you will see where they say, you will see some words like there is a time for there's a time to be silent, and there's a time to speak. Yes, family, you see this and this Bible verses. That means this is what the Bible says about that. Family, that's why you say that silence is a source of strength. Of course, you know this. Family, you swear they say that wise men are not always silent, but they know what time to be. Wise men are not always silent, but they know what time to be. Yes, what? God's word is so interesting, my friends. Wow. A family, go and read, you'll see what they say. God is the best listener. So even if you're silent and you're talking to him in that silent mode, but while you're praying, though the words may not come out, but when you're talking to him, I'm telling you, he is listening. Because the Bible says, God is the best listener. Oh, what a God we serve. What a mighty God we have. What a mighty God we serve. My God. Family, There's where you say, guard your mouth, guard your tongue, be free from trouble. Yes. And sometimes people, you talk too much. You talk too much. By the way, some years back when I was like growing up, like this is when I was young, I was like, that might end. Sometimes I just talk too much. But sometimes, you know, when you talk too much, sometimes you talk what even you're not supposed to talk. I'm telling you the truth. Sometimes I would talk too much, but I sometimes I would speak something and then I say, why did I say this? I also got some critics from my friends, and my friends were telling me, how many talk too much? And I was like, you know, sometimes when people tell you something, please you listen. You may not listen at that time, but when you go back somewhere, you will say like, so and so told me such a thing, and I'm sure he's my friend, so why did he say it? Or why did she say it? So when I went on getting some things that you talk too much, I was like, okay, you know? So when you talk too much, sometimes you talk things that you're not supposed to talk, you know? You end up even abusing people, you know? So family, this is what the Bible says. The Bible is so interesting, my friend. Family is where they say, stand silent in the presence of the sovereign Lord. Yes, of course. Now in the presence of the Lord, yes, that is where you're supposed to be silent. That is where you're supposed to talk to your God. That is where you're supposed to sing. That is where you're supposed to sing for your God. That is where you're supposed to sing for to dance for your God. There is supposed to be silence in His presence. So that's how it is. So family, I think I've explained. But for more, please go and visit this. Go and check these Bible verses. And I always tell you, read the Bible that is in the language that you understand. Family, I always tell you this. Read that Bible that is in the language that you understand. Read that Bible that is in the language that you understand. Thank you so much, family. I'm on Junior Rukundo Facebook. Rwangana Magaraga on Facebook. Kisugu Uganda Tumanimino Facebook. Those are Facebook accounts. Twitter at Amon Junior. Instagram, Amon Junior 165 1987. You're gonna get me there. There is a Facebook page for God and Our Heaven, Raj page. Family, go there, like the page, share the videos. When you're sharing, that means you're helping me so that we can spread the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ. Good news of God, or good news from God. Family, there is also YouTube account, Love Amon Jr. All Amon Jr. Rukundo. Go there, subscribe, share those videos. They are our videos, they are your videos, they are my videos, they are, you know. Share them. That means you're helping me to spread the good news and the word of our Lord. Family, it's your responsibility. It's my responsibility. It's our responsibility as believers to evangelize. Not so. I know you'll be blessed in Jesus' name. Family, I always tell you, if you haven't accepted Jesus Christ as your only personal savior, family, what are you waiting for? Some people say, better late than never, my friend. For this case, the religious case, accepting Jesus Christ as your only personal savior, I don't like that thing. Better late than never. No, please. In these things, the earlier the better. That's what I always tell you. The earlier the better. Don't say, so and so did it when I was going to die. That's so and so. This is you. Please do it, family. Your life will never remain the same if you follow the word, though. Some of you say you have accepted Jesus Christ as your only personal savior, but you're not following the word. How can you say you're following, you accepted him, when you know that the word is God, and God said through his son, you'll be able to reach him, and you're not following the word? So how does that connect? Okay, family. And also I always tell you, those of you who have not yet been baptized, you know, as a born-again Christians, you must go and be baptized. Born again Christians, you know, and you must learn a lot. You must know what's your faith, born again faith, what's accepting Jesus Christ as the only personal savior. You must know this, family. The word of God is so interesting. Of course, this is life. Not so, family. I love you all. God bless you. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, let me see. I think I've explained everything, family. But go for Bible verses. Go and check. Go and read them. Okay. I love you.